Welcome to Kant's Understanding of Knowledge and Logic. In his famous work, Critique of Pure Reason, Kant addresses the topic of transcendental logic in the section titled Transcendental Doctrine of Elements. Kant discusses the topic of transcendental logic. In his philosophy, Kant introduces the idea of transcendental logic, which holds a significant place. In this section, he begins by examining logic in general. However, before delving into this topic, Kant clarifies some important concepts that form the cornerstones of his philosophy. On one hand, Kant aims to distinguish the pure, meaning that which is independent of experience, a priori, from that which is based on experience, a posteriori. On the other hand, he aims to differentiate between the two fundamental sources of our knowledge, sensibility, Sinnlichkeit, and understanding, Verstand. Our knowledge originates from two primary sources of the mind, Gemüt. The first is sensibility, our capacity to receive impressions. The second is understanding, our power to comprehend objects through these impressions. Through sensibility, objects are given to us. Through understanding, we think about these given impressions as objects. Thus, perception, intuition, and concepts constitute all the elements of our knowledge. Therefore, neither concepts without perceptions nor perceptions without concepts can provide us with knowledge. According to Kant, these two powers or faculties cannot replace each other. Kant's understanding of general logic. In his Critique of Pure Reason, Kant addresses logic in two distinct ways: general logic and the special use of understanding. What Kant refers to as general logic is essentially what we know today as formal logic. Kant, like many philosophers of the 19th century, believed that formal logic was as precise a science as mathematics. According to Kant, general logic encompassed the necessary rules of thinking, and these rules were valid regardless of the object to which the understanding was directed. The special use of understanding, on the other hand, involves the rules of thinking correctly about specific objects. Kant divides general logic into two categories, pure logic and applied logic. Pure logic is stripped of all empirical conditions used by our understanding. In other words, pure logic is free from the influence of our senses, imagination, memory, habits, and prejudices. This means moving away from all empirical conditions on which knowledge is based. Therefore, pure logic operates with principles independent of experience, and in this sense, serves as a measure of our understanding and reason. Applied logic, on the other hand, relies on empirical principles. Before delving into Kant's understanding of transcendental logic, it is crucial to understand what he means by transcendental. Kant assigns distinct meanings to the terms transcendent and transcendental. This distinction is paramount for Kant's understanding of knowledge. While transcendental is the name Kant chose for his own philosophy, transcendent carries a negative connotation for him. On this matter, one of Kant's prominent commentators, we can grasp Kant's understanding of transcendental logic by examining the distinction he draws between general logic, that is, formal logic, and transcendental logic. Recall that, according to Kant, general logic pertains to all the necessary rules of thinking, whether empirical or independent of experience, whether analytical or synthetic. General logic holds true regardless of the subject matter of thought. On the other hand, Kant argues that transcendental logic exclusively examines the rules of synthetic a priori thinking. Or to put it more precisely, it investigates the concepts and principles of synthetic a priori thinking. We can elucidate this point as follows. Unlike formal logic, transcendental logic does not entirely disregard the content of thought. In other words, a synthetic a priori thought or judgment cannot be separated from pure intuition. The fundamental problem addressed by transcendental logic, which is essentially the fundamental problem of transcendental philosophy itself, is the question of whether knowledge that is both a priori and synthetic is possible. Transcendental logic is divided into two parts, the doctrine of elements and the doctrine of method. The transcendental doctrine of method seeks to determine the formal conditions of the system of pure reason. The transcendental doctrine of elements, in turn, is divided into transcendental analytic and transcendental dialectic. Transcendental dialectic is the section where the illusions of pure reason are addressed. In our next lesson, we will begin examining transcendental analytic and transcendental dialectic, the two main parts of transcendental logic. In this chapter, we provided a general overview of Kant's understanding of logic. We learned some fundamental concepts related to Kant's understanding of logic and knowledge, and we examined the important distinctions he makes between different types of logic. See you in the next chapter.